please be aware of the things that your friends are doing. And honestly, don't be afraid to like stand up and say like, you know what? I don't stand for that. Like, you know, I feel like your friends, even if you having friends that aren't living the same life as you, like it's okay to be like, y'all, look, I'm not involved in that. You shouldn't do things just to fit in. You know, I kind of feel like that's like childish, but people really do still do that. You fear, like, I have been in situations where it's like, I don't want to tell my friends stuff because I don't want for them to look at me like, oh, she thinks she's holier than thou, or she thinks she's better than us. So I'll just be like, I mean, I may not be involved in it, but I can clearly see that you're going down the wrong path and I tell you something, then that doesn't make me a true friend. You know, I was, the thing that God had really dealt with me on my friendship was like, oh my God, am I being a good friend? I have friends that could be going through something spiritually, that could be battling things, and I never sit down and pray for them on that situation. Am I really a good friend? It doesn't matter how many times I didn't pay for them to go out to eat, how much time I spend with them. This is what truly defines good friendship. If whenever they are struggling with something, I am not there to help them, I'm not there to get down on my knees and pray for their deliverance in that thing, then I'm not being doing my job spiritually as a good friend. I want that, and I want for other people to be that to me. If I'm gonna have friends, I want to be able to trust you and be able to tell you, hey, look, man, I've been going through this, like, I've really been struggling with this thing. And you should not have a friend to tell you, girl, I've been doing the same thing. Like, no, like, and honestly, they may be going through the same thing, but it shouldn't be a session where it's like, it's okay, and we making each other feel okay for our wrongdoings. We supposed to push each other to be better. So make sure y'all get y'all a friend that's like, you know what, whether you've been going through it, whether you've been through it, I'm praying with you, and we're gonna help each other get out of this thing. Because just like with relationships, with a boy and a girl in marriage, how they're supposed to help you be the best version of yourself, friends are also supposed to reflect that. So my next scripture, 1 Corinthians 15 and 33, don't fool yourself. Bad friends will destroy you. Be sensible and stop sinning. Ooh! Well, all right, Lord. Be sensible and stop sinning. You should be embarrassed that some people still don't know God. Oh my God. Like, you know what? This right here, y'all, I could tell y'all about a place where I was at when I had friends and they did not know anything about God. They was not going to church and I was still their friend. Like, the word is even saying, like, you should be embarrassed that your friend don't see the God in you, and you're not even encouraging your friend to get to know God more. You should be embarrassed. And honestly, y'all, that is really embarrassing. Like, what? When you got friends and they don't even know that you love God, or if they do know that you love God, they not even being respectful of, you know, the God in you, then you should check yourself. They should be like, you know what? I'm not even gonna play this around her. I'm not even gonna speak certain things around her because of what she stands for. And I mean, as long as people respect your walk, that is important. But if you not showing no signs of God in your friendships, if they just cussing up a storm in front of you and they don't have no type of sensitivity, like, and I'm not saying that, you know, if you cuss, you cuss, hallelujah. I'm just saying, some people, you know, they just don't have no type of tact. And it's just like, they don't even feel like different in your presence, then that is a problem. And you should check yourself and say, God, make me a better example to the people around me. I like that scripture, that was deep. I felt that one on the inside. And also, this is gonna be my last point that I'm gonna tag on. As far as friendships, we argue, we fuss. You gonna have disagreements with your friends, especially if you really close to a person. Nothing should be peaches and cream all the time. If you got a friend and they agreeing with you on everything, that is a problem. Do not hang out, just be like, you know what, love? You a yes man, and I don't need a yes man. I don't need yes men in my corner. You know, my own flesh is gonna be my yes man. I need somebody to be like, do you think that that's really the right thing to do? Or a person to be like, bro, you ain't got no job, go get a job. Here, I will drive you in my car and take you to get some applications. Bro, you want to do this? Let me encourage you. Let's look up some things on how to be better in your gifts, in your craft. Do not just be with somebody that's gonna sit there and be content with you staying at a regular level. Or if you do something bad, they just like, they don't care. And y'all gonna have disagreements, especially if they're a good friend. You're gonna fight, and they might do things that you may have felt have been disloyal. That's I feel like that's a lot of people issues. That's why they got trust issues with people, because they be like, this why I ain't got no friends. I ride solo because these people are shut in. Talked about you, went and told your business to somebody else, and that is wrong. If you did, that's your down bad. That's not the type of friends that we are supposed to be. Because the one thing about me, if I feel a way about you and you are my friend, I'm not gonna sit up here and talk to somebody else and say like, yes, she wrong for doing that. No, I'm gonna go and tell you first. I might say it to somebody else after that if we all, but I'm gonna tell you first because I honestly feel like that is my job. That's my duty. Like, I feel like I'm so fake if I feel a way about somebody or I feel that you're making the wrong decision in life and I don't tell you nothing, then I feel fake. Like, I can't just sit and be like, she wrong for that, and I'm just not gonna tell her that that is not what God has for her, or she wrong for doing that to that boy, and I'm just not, that's not, I feel like you gotta be honest. But for the disloyal friends or people that have had friends be disloyal to you, if they are making the necessary efforts and steps to try to mend the relationship, I got a scripture for you. Ephesians 4:32, it says, instead, be kind and merciful and forgive others just as God forgave you because of Christ. So y'all, we can't just be holding grudges on people. It's okay to also be on some stuff like, you know what? I forgive you, but our friendship may never be the same. You may have had a situation where y'all was best friends and they done something dirty. Just forgive them. Even if the relationship may never be how it was, forgive that person and still show them love. Don't be holding grudges on people. Every time you see them, you want to fight. All that extra junk, let it go. The word says, be kind and be merciful. When you see that person in the store, you should still be able to give them a hug and check on them and see how you doing. That's maturity. That is a Christ-like attitude. Y'all understand me? So that's all that I have for today. Y'all be better friends. Y'all check on your listen. So another thing I want to say before we close out is another thing that I want to say before we close out is you might be that person that has a friend that is going through a lot. You might be the person that is carrying the weight for somebody that is like, man, I just gotta be that for my friend because they're going through so much stuff. And y'all, it's okay to not be able to do that sometimes. I think you gotta know yourself and know where you are to be able to say like, you know what, I need to work on myself before I try to carry the weight for somebody else. And guess what, if you're not that friend, then be honest with them and tell them, look, I'm gonna be praying for you, but I can't do that for you, son. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And y'all comment and let me know what are the topics that y'all want for me to talk about, because you know I gotta be inspired by God, but I want to know what y'all want to hear. So thank you so much. Friends are in the minds of each other. So like my something I'm in that ever person since the first day. I is never attracting you to them. This was the there first is something time. Common in yeah, there that the is attracting.